Something went wrong. Damn it! Why are you still breaking shit? Good job, Elon Musk. I can't even tweet out my stream to my Twitter page. Something went wrong. This request looks like it may have been automated. Holy shit. Elon Musk, you really just went and broke everything, didn't you? Alright, well, post and share from the others. We should be good to go. Alright, let's go. I'm gonna start off with main. Since they won't let me do the side quest that I picked up.
First we find Isabel.
Heard a bloke saying he saw ghosts on the far side.
I saw it with my own eyes. The whole of Oriflam.
Garrison's being sorely tested.
Times are hard.
A custom is most welcome, my lady.
Hey girl, how goes it?
My lord, my lady.
We received the dame's message. There have been sightings of strange creatures, I understand.
With the blue eyes. Yes. Like a Kashyyyk, but different. They've taken so many. I've lost count.
A Kashyyyk, but different.
Ultimus thralls. And what of your mistress? Is she here?
Oh, no. She went to the garrison to ask what they were planning on doing about all this.
Then we'll look for her there.
You know, at one point I was going to look up to see how many hunts there were, because right now I've done 16 of them. Is that all of them, or is there more to come? I don't know. I was going to Google it, and then I completely forgot about this now. I didn't have any legs. Pain! I can't feel my legs! Bubba, you ain't got no legs!
Please!
Half the garrison's been slaughtered by those things. We lost the captain this very morning.
We've tried requesting reinforcements, but there's been no word from the capital or the Dominion in days! What more would you have us do?
I would have you do your duty. Those at the Vale look to me for protection. And protect them I shall. Because they are my charges, and that is my duty. In case you have forgotten, the people of this town are your charges. But more than that, they are your people, your sisters, your brothers, your lovers. So you have a choice.
If we're in Alabama, they're all the same.
Take your sword and watch as they are slaughtered, or take it up and do what is right.
She speaks the truth, you know. This here, it's all we have. It's all that's left.
What we have left is our lives. Do you really want us to lose them as well?
Not if we don't have to. Look, there's a cask under the captain's bunk. Let's talk about this over a drink, eh?
I'm listening.
Great, get drunk and then the monster's attacking. You're too drunk to fight back.
Ah, oh, Clive. I didn't expect help to arrive so quickly. And sought to take matters into my own hands.
It was a noble effort, but I thought you might still need some support.
How like you to consider my need.
Get in there, Jill.
The way the survivors speak of them, one would think they appeared out of thin air.
And they may have.
And perhaps they did. It's hard to know what to believe these days.
We'll talk to the survivors.
That thing, it took off the captain's head. Before we could even draw his steel.
I'm not going back out there. You hear me? Fuck this!
Body language set.
Did you see the creatures that attacked you?
Creatures? Yeah, they came out of nowhere. They went for Joseph first, then me, and then they were just gone.
Do you remember where you were?
On the road from Oriflam. We just passed Maul when... Where's my Joseph?
It's all right. Just rest now.
Joseph was eaten by a bear. Terrible trap.
You're a pikeman, yes? What happened?
I've got family and more. I heard the flood was spreading, so I went to see if they were all right. And a pack of them glowing things found me in the meadow. I ran for my life. I never did get to the village.
Leave that to us.
At least we have an idea of where the thralls might be now. We should head for more. You're safe now.
Yeah, I wouldn't say safe just yet. Once I take care of things, then you'll be safe.
I assume you have a plan.
It was all they could do to escape. They just left the bodies there in the flood.
They should.
Good girl.
Any enemies out here? Only you'd see one or two just wandering around.
Clive, look.
I see them. With me.
She thought she was gonna have to bust out Shiva for it. Come on, Joe, we're better than that.
Do you think there are more?
There are always more. But I'd say we've done what we can for the time being.
Then we should let Isabel know.
You have the town's thanks.
Don't thank us yet. There will be more. Many more. And you'll need to be ready for them.
Oh, we shall. Isn't that right, Captain?
Yes, m'lady. The garrison will be ready.
Philippe here has convinced most of the men to remain at their posts, for now at least.
Hearing that the Dane would look kindly on any man who committed himself to the task certainly didn't hurt. It's not the most selfless of motives, I'll admit. Whatever it takes, eh? Now me, I never needed convincing. I became a soldier to protect the people I love. And the people I love include the one standing before me.
Aww.
Handsome and chivalrous.
I was trying to get some tonight.
Now, if you don't mind, I have sentries to post. M'lady.
Lest you wonder, I'm not foolish enough to believe that this has solved all of my problems. But it has solved one, and that's one fewer than I had this morning. Thank you again, Clive.
Right now, can I give her the damn star and then give Martha the star?
Our friends seem to have things under control. For now, at least. Let's go and put Otto's mind at rest.
Nope, side quest still locked.
Turn up at ours from all our friends thanking you for your timely intervention. How is it you always manage to arrive at just the right moment?
Magic.
Luck, I suppose. Any word on the rest of the realm?
Let's see. Storm's still crying out for Mother Crystals. The nations are still in chaos. And the skies are still the color of a kick in the kidneys 2 days on. So...
Right.
Clive... We knew this was going to happen. Well, not the bleeding skies part, but you take my point. Now's not the time to second guess yourself. Now's the time to visit the infirmary. Taya says your brother's awake.
Thank you, Otto.
I might just do that if I can't do my side quest I want to do. Took out of my hands.
So it was not Sylvester, but Olivier who served as Ultima's puppet. And when Dion learned of this, he sought to slay the fiend. Only for his father to take the spear that would have freed him. Enough to drive a man to madness.
Small wonder he hasn't stirred. I would be afraid to wake.
Had I but reached out to him sooner, warned him of the threat Ultima posed. But now, both an empire and her prince lie broken.
Joshua, what do you know of Ultima?
A bitch, but he wants you, so
very
I
little,
him.
I'm afraid. Despite my best efforts. 18 years ago, as I lay buried beneath the rubble of Phoenix Gate, 'twas not death who came for me, but another. And it was while in my rescuer's care, I first heard of Ultima. I've been chasing his shadow ever since. Ultima is driven by some deep, dark purpose, and for whatever reason, it would seem you are crucial to his designs. He will stop at nothing to have you, even if that means toppling an empire.
But why me? What possible use could I be to such a creature?
That is one of many answers that have eluded me. Yet, I am certain of this. It is not mere chance. You were chosen for a reason. All dominants carry within them the might of an icon. Nigh limitless power that is at once acutely limited. I wield fire, and only fire.
And I only ice. 8 wardens for 8 elements. But you, Clive.
You got all but, what, 2 left now?
You are different. You're special. Your abilities begin with the flames of Ifrit. But they do not end there. The fact Ifrit can even exist goes against everything we thought we knew of dominance. Perhaps Ultima has been waiting for one such as you, whose potential is truly limitless.
I've encountered that thing several times now. If it or he, as you say, needs me, why hasn't he claimed me as he did the boy?
Were I to hazard a guess, I'd say the two of you are somehow incompatible. His mind not properly attuned to your body.
His mind?
Mind, awareness, spirit, call it what you wish. But I believe Ultima to be an embodiment of the concept. This is why I struggle and fail to contain him here inside me.
I'm sorry. Inside you?
With every setting sun, I feel my strength wane. And though the Phoenix's flames mend the prison I have made for Ultima, they do so at a cost. We must find a means to bring an end to him. Before I meet my own.
What were you thinking?
It was that or let him take Clive. And I've always had a soft spot for my brother.
But that doesn't mean you should sacrifice yourself to save me.
Joshua. Clive, it's Gav. There's an army of Akashic at the gates of Canver.
Well, what's the short of it?
Tyre told you. The capital of the Free Cities is under siege by an army of monstrosities.
Our eyes will kiss some ass.
The City Guard are doing their best to stem the tide, but numbers ain't on their side.
What of Lord Byron and Mid? Were they able to escape?
No, but they're all right for now. They're hiding with Gav at midship.
We have to get them out of there.
And we shall. Otto, prepare a stolas. Tell Gav to stay exactly where he is.
Understood.
Vivian. What's the swiftest route to the Free Cities?
That sounds like a question for the map. Look here. This road, through Tabor, should provide the least trouble.
Good.
What a coincidence. Tabor is exactly where I'm bound.
Joshua, Bed is where you should be bound.
You don't think I told him the exact same thing?
Were Tyre not such a talented healer, I would surely have been inclined to agree. But, thanks to her ministrations, I feel I may safely rejoin my attendant, who was to wait for me in Tabor if we became separated.
All right, we travel together.
Clive!
If he stays close to me, he'll be fine.
Thank you. Brother.
I'll look after him.
Oh, can I finally deliver? Looks like they're unlocked. Oh, but it won't let me go there. Fuckers. They're just absolutely refusing to let me get this dang side quest on, aren't they?
It's like a dream, the four of us out walking like we used to. Enjoying this, are you? Gav and the others could be in danger as we speak.
Yeah, fuck them.
You're right. I'm sorry. Yote is a fine scout. If Canville was attacked, she will already have begun gathering information.
Tabor isn't far. We should pick up the pace.
Weird, but alright.
We can use the ruins to cross the ravine.
Assuming they will allow it, the echoes have a will of their own.
Oh shit, there's still a couple of them left. I killed them already. Farewell.
Tell us about Yote, Joshua.
She's strong-willed, loyal, and deadly with a blade. Much like Clive, but with better manners.
Now then, bound for the free cities, perhaps? Oh, no need to say if you'd rather not. We all have our reasons. Ain't exactly feeling like sharing with strangers myself at the mo. Truth be told, I need a bit of inspiration. Don't know which way to turn no more. Was doing a roaring trade back in Oriflam, right up until the poor Drake lost her noggin. So, thought I'd try me luck in the desert. And the Fang went the same way. And don't get me started on the mess in the bloomin' Dominion. Suppose I could try Canver next. But knowing my luck, the old place be crawling with the works, boy, I'd even set out me stall. But as I always say, where there's crisis, there's opportunity. The opportunity to mint gil, that is. So, where to next?
Is there any money to holy shit. Cash?
Do orcs even carry gil?
Was not expecting him to talk that long. We're done fucked up. Help.
You're injured. What happened here? Where are your comrades?
The ether flood. Up ahead. It swallowed our camp while we slept. My own men did this. Turned. Every last one of them. There's a village not far from here. Tabor. The people were kind to us. It's only a matter of time before... they won't stand a chance. We can't let those monsters reach the...
I'll go.
All right, I guess I'll go save them too.
Thank you.
Rest well, soldier. He said the encampment was close. Let's hope the Akashic are still there.
Another ether flood. They're everywhere now.
We can't go around it.
Then we'll just have to be careful.
Good. Got here in time.
That's why he was already over $300.
That doesn't sound like an Akashic.
It all goes on smooth. Like, bitch, all alcohol goes on like water with you because you're an alcoholic.
You're with the battalion?
I am. I heard the fighting.
Taken care of. One of your brothers in arms told me what happened and asked for help.
Another survivor? Where is he?
His wounds were too deep.
He was right to send you. Those things you slew are no longer my brothers. Tabor is safe thanks to you. Here, you've earned it.
Yes, on the meteor.
You seem familiar.
You must have me confused with someone else.
Wait. That scar.
Son of a whore. You're Sid. I was there in Cosnus when you killed my brothers. I was there in Rosalith when you killed my commander.
My war with Hugo Kupka is over. I bear no ill will toward those who followed him.
And what of my ill will? Coward! Draw your steel.
Lord really want to die, dude.
Shall be avenged!
When your wounds have healed and your head has cooled, come and find me if you must. Though I hazard your life would be better spent in service of those who need it. Or have you forgotten your oath to the Republic?
My oath? What would you know of oaths?
I know how hard they are to keep. Which is why I'm giving you the chance to keep yours.
Hey dude, if you go after me right now, you're gonna die. Rather quickly.
I won't be deceived. Lord Kupka told us of your crimes. You are an outlaw. A murderer, not some...
man. Like you or anyone else.
I am nothing like you. But if you're not gonna kill me, then go. Just know that I will find you, Sid. Someday.
Alright, dude, you can barely stand. There'd be no point in finding you right now. Someone told me it's just a scratch. It's a flesh wound. I've had worse. Get back here, I'll bite your kneecaps off. Ah, shit.
Get him! Go for it! Get him!
We're nearly there.
Have you been to Tabor before?
There are a few places I haven't.
Where now, Joshua?
There is a residence just inside the city gates. She awaits us within.
All right, we made it.
My Lord Marquis, it is an honor. I am Yote, Knight of the Undying, charged with the protection of His Grace Joshua Rosfield, Keeper of the Flame of the Phoenix.
Of course. It all makes sense now.
Would you care to elaborate?
The Undying are loyal servants to the Ducal Throne. Or more specifically, to its heir. They have served our family for generations, albeit from the shadows.
Since their inception, they have been tasked with the preservation and enactment of the rites of ancestral communion. After the events at Phoenix Gate, it was the Undying who delivered me to safety. And since the day I left Rosaria, Yote has been my constant companion and protector. Without her sword, I would not have survived my journey across the realm.
Rise, Lady Yote. You saved my brother. I owe you a debt I can never repay.
I but did my duty.
Come now, tell us what you've discovered.
Your Grace, it is as you feared. The vessel we spied off the coast of the Crystalline Dominion on the night of her fall. It was the Einherjar. Beyond any doubt.
The Black Galleon.
Joshua. The Einherjar is the Royalist's flagship. What business would they have in the Dominion?
This is not gonna go well, Liz.
Upon learning of Walud's involvement in recent events at Drake's Fang, I sensed the malign influence of Ultima, and bid Yote and the Undying look into the matter.
We have reason to believe that the Black Galleon weighed anchor shortly after the fighting began, and set a course due south.
For Canva. Then it is Waluda knights who besiege the cities.
What is left of them, yes. And the Black Galleon sails up at one man's behest. Barnabas Tharm.
But are we truly safe here in the Agora?
No.
The city guard is nowhere to be safe. If that's what you're implying.
All the more reason for them to run.
Well, you are free to leave. Lord Minister.
Markets abandoned, warehouses aflame, blackened hulls choking every port in the capital. Canva is ruined.
The realm teeters on the brink of chaos, and all you can think about is commerce.
Forgive us. We were not aware Dalmechia now subsisted on charity.
Quite. How dare you?
Fight, 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 fight.
Distinguished members of the council, you must forgive His Majesty this intrusion.
What did you... What is the meaning of this?
A trifle crowded, but I fear it will have to serve, my liege.
Very well.
My colleagues, do you not see? The king, he has come to save us from the Akashic.
Oh, you're so wrong.
He is a gift from the heavens, divine intervention, our very salvation.
And of course, if it is compensation he requires, we would be most willing to negotiate a fair price for services rendered.
Fools. Your ignorance unbecomes you.
Your Majesty, correct me if I'm wrong, but I would swear that the fiends washing the cobbles of Kanva with the blood of her citizens wear the colors of Walud. Ha! So you do not deny it. Guards, fetter them and see our guests to the dungeons!
Oh, you force that saps.
That you should imagine yourselves worthy of salvation.
Oh, shit.
The girl is still here, somewhere in the city. Her consciousness fair dripping with her late father's hubris. A consciousness to which Muthos is inextricably bound and inexorably drawn.
Oh, he's looking for guilt,
see
too?
That he is made welcome.
Yes, Your Majesty.
Come, Muthos. Surely the Prince's light cannot have sated you.
Dun, dun, dun! Insert dramatic background music here. Boy, there it is.
So then, how long has Walud been under Ultima's control?
How long indeed? Based on what we know of Barnabas's actions, I would guess some few years, mayhap more.
But to what end? What does Ultima want?
The tapestry. Show them.
You've seen that ever, but we don't see the bottom part of it.
Breath, and now here. But what is it?
It is old, ancient, even. Naught remains of the faith it represents, save what can be gleaned from the image itself. None could tell me what the one in the apodotry meant. Even the undying. But I believe it may be the key to discerning Ultima's purpose. That figure in the center. The one beneath whom the icons congregate, that I believe to be Ultima. He is a god, or at least godlike. His very existence beyond our ken. The icons, and by extension their dominance, are meant to be his subjects. And while some, like Barnabas, have accepted this role, others have rejected it. Like you, Clive, which is rather inconvenient, as it appears he needs you most of all. And gods don't like to be disobeyed.
No, I don't suppose they do.
Clive, may I tell Yote of the lake?
By all means.
Yote, I will be accompanying my brother to the Free Cities. Whilst we are afield, I would have you watch over those Clive has made his wards. Umielos delan tuisag ilith. Though well concealed, the hideaway lacks trained fighters to defend its occupants should they be discovered.
But it is my duty to...
As it has ever been my brother's duty, remember.
If that is your wish, Your Grace. But please be safe. If aught were to befall you, I...
You have my word.
Farewell, my lord, my lady.
We are in your debt, Yote.
But she's gone now. The shadows protected him for years, just gone.
Cares for you very deeply.
And I her, which is why I had to let her go.
So she's gone. Why?
Opportunity beckons. Who among you is bold enough to heed?
Yes, I can finally do these side missions. About friggin' time. I have my life dedicated to getting this side mission done.
Clive, we weren't expecting you.
I wasn't expecting to be here. But it seems we still owe you a considerable amount of coin for your help with our rebuilding efforts. And though I doubt it's what you were expecting, we were hoping you'd take this as payment.
A star, Ruby? I can't accept this. It's worth at least twice what you owe me. More if you can find yourself the right buyer.
And find yourself
the difference is interest.
Interest? If word got out I charged that much, no one would ever borrow from me again. Anyway, why are you the one here asking me about this? I'd have expected Otto. Bit much sending the Lord Marquis out to sell your debts, isn't it? The old goat working himself to death again.
Something like that. Most days I think he's the only reason the hideaway's still standing.
Same as always, eh? Back when the place was nothing but a twinkle in the eye of a recently retired Lord Commander, word is he was the first ones he'd reached out to. Probably knew that without his strong arm and level head, the idea would never get off the ground. Sid may have been the face of the hideaway, but Otto's always been the backbone. And when Sid passed away, we were all worried that would be the end of it. That Otto would just give up.
His death was hard on everyone. But it must have hit Otto hardest of all.
But he didn't give up, did he? Quite the opposite, in fact. If I recall, he was the one who nominated you as Sid's replacement and rallied the rest around you. I reckon what he saw in Sid, he saw in you too. And don't we all? Doesn't hurt that you're half as stubborn and twice as handsome, neither.
Well, thank you.
That, and you keep good company.
I suppose I do.
I got Joe with me. I keep great company. Roll out. Roll out.
I got peppers to numb your tongue up.
There were ghosts at the gates, not Daisy.
Those things I said before.
M'lady, I come bearing gifts.
Gifts? Whatever is the occasion? Oh my. Clive, you really have outdone yourself.
Otto asked me to give it to you. To settle the hideaway's debt with the Veil. And to compensate you for the time it took us to do so.
You disappoint me, Clive. I thought you might finally be warming to me. Tell Otto he can keep his baubles. I tried to tell him as much the first time around. The man owes me nothing, nor does the hideaway. My contribution to the restoration effort was made freely and willingly. It was the least I could do.
You once told me Sid did you a kindness. I'd like to do the same. Please, accept it. For my sake.
Maybe let us, you know,
and for ours, money in for all of us. For all you've done.
It is rather fetching, isn't it? Very well. Otto is lucky to have you, Clive. I doubt anything could ever replace his son. But you and the others at the hideaway are the closest thing he has to family.
Otto had a son.
Long ago. Yes. Sid told me Otto lost him when he was just a boy, and blamed himself for not being able to stop it. I don't know how it happened, whether there was anything he could have done, but it was clear that it weighed heavily on him.
I didn't know.
How could you have? I doubt anyone did. Besides Sid, I've never met a man more keen to bear his sorrows in stoic silence. An ill habit, given that both have always been surrounded by friends desperate to help them.
I'm beginning to see that. Go, we'll want to know the stones were delivered. If he's still with us.
Poor guy, I had to deliver one to Karen.
There's barely been a shipment in since the sky started falling.
Did you see that? Tell me you saw that.
Oh, there might be a new hunt.
Ghost.
Means I had to buzz out the Google machine.
I see. So Lady Karen accepted the ruby.
Ah, oh, about that. I tried my best, but she was just too stubborn to take it. She threw it right back in my face, in fact, and told me I could stick my stupid stone where the sun don't shine.
Karen refused payment.
I hope it wasn't something I said.
I'm sure you were as tactful as ever. Let me see what I can do.
Oh, wonderful. I hope you have better luck than I did.
Lady Karen,
take it.
Goad tells me you weren't happy with our offer. Would you prefer the debt was repaid in coin?
What debt? I don't recall lending any of you lot me hard-earned gil. I may have tossed a talent or two in the Hideaway's coffers, but those were donations. And you can hardly call it charity if you go asking for it back.
Of course not. But one good turn deserves another. And our circumstances have changed. Surely you wouldn't shun the gratitude of a pauper who happened to have become a prince.
Oh, so you're a prince now, are you? Fine. But I'm selling it and taking what I'm owed, then you're getting the rest whether you like it or not.
Exactly what I was hoping for from the others. They saw the keep what they're owed.
Get this? A decent trader might nab 1,000 talents for a star ruby. A canny one, meanwhile, might claim it were nicked from the belt of Sid the Outlaw himself and ask twice as much. Might be I already have a buyer in mind. Might be you even know her. A fine continental maid whose beauty's only eclipsed by a guile in commerce. You wouldn't mind, would you?
Not at all. Just be sure to tell her that it's always a pleasure doing business.
And the others should have sold theirs, kept what they were owed, and kept half of the profit, and then given us the other half of the profit.
I hear you ended up delivering all 3 stones. Thanks to this lump, I sometimes wonder what I pay you for.
Speaking of which, I still haven't been paid last month's wages.
Oh, so you remember what's owed to you then? Get your ass behind that disc of yours and don't get up before those ledges are square.
Right away.
I've seen that before.
Yeah. Plenty of times. It was the only goblet Sid ever used, either out of habit, or because the filthy soul couldn't be bothered to find a clean one.
I knew so little about him.
And most people.
Martha and the Dame both seem to have fond memories of him.
Huh. I bet they do.
How long did you know Sid before he...
Before he died. 20 summers, give or take. Back in the day, I was a purser on a trade ship, which is where I met him. He bought passage to, I forget where. And having nothing better to do on the long nights, we set up drinking island rum till the morning bell dragged me back to my duties. Quit my post not long after that, on account of making a fine maiden's belly fat. But me and Sid stayed close. Promising we'd one day sail the seas again.
He lied the end.
Before fate stepped in and said she was having none of it. The magic woke inside my son soon after his first name day, and there was no hiding his knack.
Couldn't you and your family have?
My family were the ones who summoned the constable. Wanted the monster taken away. I couldn't turn my back on him. Forget what I felt. And I couldn't for the life of me understand how they could. Luckily, Sid was of the same mind as me. It was him who stood beside me when all I wanted was to tear the whole world down. Him who cried for me when I had no tears left of my own. Him who swore he'd do everything he could to stop it from happening again. And he was true to his word, too. Left the Royal Army once and for all. His ranks, his ribbons, gone.
And now he's dead.
Just like that. Womp
womp.
Threw away everything he had. All to right a wrong that no one else had the courage to face. I knew then I'd follow that man to the ends of the earth. Was always too clever for his own good, was Sid.
saw the world for what it really was, while the rest of us were content to go along with the lie we were shown. And it can't have been easy, bearing that burden alone. But he didn't let it stop him. He never lost faith in what he believed was right. And that gave us faith in him. Faith he'd steer us true. So I swore to myself that I'd always be right behind him, ready to catch the stubborn sod if ever he should fall.
Now he's dead.
But I couldn't even do that. Ignore me. Just the ramblings of a tired old man. Leave that lot. I'll tidy it up in a bit.
This. This is Sid's handwriting. Dear Otto.
I may be drunk, but I wanted you to know this place would be fucked without you. Love you, you grumpy old sod.
This note.
What about it?
Sid was right. Without you, we'd all be lost.
You should have bloody well said so then. Just once. Before he went. But then, why would he? Him or anyone? I'd only have told him to piss off. You're wrong, though. Both of you. It was never just me keeping the hideaway afloat. It was all of us. I just shoved people in the right direction, and I barely seem to be able to do that anymore.
Why don't we hear tornado sirens going off?
Would you rather go with the helm?
Well, maybe I've got a few more years left in me.
I'm going to hold you to that, Otto.
Ooh, because it's really bad just south of here.
Before you go.
Like, less than a mile south of here. Ooh, that is nasty according to the weather channel.
Sid wanted you to have this.
It's kind of moving north a little bit, but it won't be here until about another hour.
This will do me just fine.
Well, that's why your tornado siren's going off. Well, my streaming gets interrupted immediately. It's because I lost power. Because something went
thanks
poorly south of here.
Ray of sunshine. I'll see if I can't pay you back.
Already have.
Well, you're here trying to enjoy Final Fantasy 16 all of a sudden.
Oh, that's tornado siren.
And they're still going off. Usually they only go off about once or twice.
Did you see that? Tell me you saw that.
Alright, just did several mains, and I'll see some sides in. One more sides in.
It seems the hideaway's lost its
blasted book. Here, you put me in this situation, Clive. You can bloody well get me out of it. I need a hand with a recipe.
Are you sure it's me you're looking for? I'm not much of a cook.
I'm all the cook will be needing, thank you very much. What I want from you is a little of your time, right? Oh, and perhaps your sword.
I got a sword for you, baby.
Remember Ivan's stew, right? Well, despite the look of the thing, and that awful stench, people wolf it down. So I thought I'd try making one of these supposed masterpieces myself. Had a peek at the book and gave it a go, but, well...
It wasn't as straightforward as you'd hoped. Yvonne had the same problem.
Yeah, but this is my blooming kitchen, and I will not be outdone! So if you don't want to be seen as playing favorites, I suggest you lend me a hand.
I've never been one to play favorites, Molly. And I would be only too happy to lend you a hand. So, what's on the menu this time?
A fried mortress of skyworm. That's one heck of a name, innit? Recipe seemed easy enough to an old hand like myself. Thought I'd followed it to a T. Only, turns out skyworm livers and Drake's mint are not what I thought they were. At least I hope they're not, given the rancid mess they made.
Yvonne said the recipes in the culinary pilgrimage date back centuries. Who's to say the ingredients even exist anymore?
Well, that's a question for a scholar, wouldn't you say? Perhaps you know
anyone? I might just know a scholar.
Kindly old fella who haunts the shelves, maybe?
Fine. I'll go and speak to Harpocrates. Perhaps he'll know something. And if he does, I'll see if I can find your ingredients for you.
You do that. Lest we forget, you've got a reputation to uphold.
And it's pretty funny because, like, right now my house is all bright and sunny. The Warner Weather Channel and the tornado sirens, it's nasty outside. This is south of here.
Norseman Harpocrates, I've come to pick your brain if you don't mind. It's about the book you lent Yvonne.
Ah, Valisthea, A Culinary Pilgrimage, a classic. One of my favorites, in fact. The young man did a wonderful job with the Chancellor's stew. I do hope we shall be able to sample more such marvels in due course.
That's actually why I'm here. I don't suppose you know where I might find skyworm livers and Drake's mint.
Ah, so the fabled Sanbriquois delicacy is next on the menu. Delightful. The descriptions of fried mortress never fail to make my mouth water. Now, skyworm is a somewhat antiquated name for the wyvern, their ground livers being the paste from which the mortress is made.
Dragon livers. How very Sanbriquois.
One would have thought the disciples of Bahamut would have a touch more reverence for their icon's brethren, but apparently not. I believe the specific dragon the recipe demands is the blueback wyvern, said to be the very color of the sea beside which it resides.
So we know where to look for our liver. But what about the Drake's mint?
Saint's bonnet, in contemporary parlance. A herb which grows along the North Reach coast. I gather that one can locate the cheerful yellow flowers by their heady scent alone, so I'm sure you'll have no trouble finding them. I may add that people once believed game was best served with the flora that sustained it in life. In which regard, fried mortress of skyworm is undoubtedly a typical dish of the time.
Meaning that if I find one, I find the other. To Northreach, then.
Best of luck, Clive. And do save me a bite once the dish is complete.
All right, Northreach coaches, that is... through the city, get around it, or
there
through
ghosts
it.
At the gates, not days.
You needn't fret. The creatures.
To the meadows, then.
National Weather Service, special marine warning.
Oh, that was the brother. What the shit was that?
Over here!
Apocrates said I should be able to find what I'm looking for somewhere nearby. Bright blue dragons and bright yellow flowers. Should be easy enough to spot.
There's yellow flowers. There's a blue dragon.
This must be our wyvern. Right. Let's get this over with.
Oh shit, I wasn't even paying attention.
Get him! The wyvern's liver. Now I just need to find the herbs. Bright yellow with a heady scent.
Ta-da.
I think that's everything Molly needs.
That's pretty cool that the game brought that up, because that's been an issue with some of the history books, but cookbooks, so forth, of what's with this ingredient? The fuck is that?
The hideaway's lost its appetite.
And they gotta try to figure out what the hell it
is. Did you have that word with Tomes then?
I did, and he was as helpful as ever. He told me exactly where to look, in fact.
And what precisely will I be cooking up? Or is it better not to know?
Blueback wyvern liver. And, a herb known as Saint's Bonnet.
Ah, wyvern livers, was it? Well, at least it weren't actual worms, I suppose. Now then, you stay right where you are. I've got some cooking to do. Let's hope these grand old chefs of yore knew what they were on about. And here we have it. Fried mortress of skyworm. Ivan's offered to make sure it's fit for consumption. Well, I say offered. He as good as begged.
And rightly so. Is there any higher honor than partaking in a slice of culinary history?
Don't down me, bro.
So, not fit for consumption, then.
What witchery is this? The crackle of the crust gives way to an almost violent richness. Yet, it is the piquant kiss of the saint's bonnet that tames this savage dish. It is a tour de force, a force of nature even, a maelstrom of flavor and sensation. A graceful beast emerging from centuries of slumber.
I think he likes it.
Well, I can't quite tell with all that nonsense he's talking. But I reckon you might be right. It was decent then, I take it.
Decent? It's remarkable. And I defy any man to say a word to the contrary. Sid, might I suggest that you command a party of your finest men and women to procure a dozen blueback wyverns forthwith?
I'll give it some thought.
Let's go check the hunter's board. Pretty sure it showed a new hunt. I don't want to get into any, like, involved main missions right now, because the storm's coming, moves north, I have to turn everything off. The Pack. A team of curse breakers traveling through Tabor. Oh, because we just opened up a new area. That makes sense. Please let me be. Yes.
Opportunity beckons.
You want anything there?
Take a look at my wares.
Ash. Have I?
Of course.
I got 40 of those desert roses, dang.
A fine choice.
Gilba, Gilba, Gilba. Do I have any? I do.
It's a deal. Take care.
No, I want to do the hunt. Leave me alone. I said, like, the main mission thing was 500 yards away. What the fuck's going on? Leave me alone.
Cyril. How fares the search?
Well, Your Grace, my report shall be with you ere long.
Ah, yes. Yote is otherwise engaged, at my behest.
And the duty of wardenship?
Fulfilled. For as you see, I've been reunited with my first shield.
I am Cyril, Knight of the Undying and bearer of the Burning Quill, charged with chronicling the mortal deeds
of His
Grace. This piece
only made over 400,000 tips. Holy
keeper
shit.
Keeper of the Flame of the Phoenix and rightful Archduke of Rosaria.
And he's up to 518 members.
I entrusted
members.
Cyril here with overseeing the investigation into Ultima's origins. Findings from his brothers and sisters afield are delivered here to be collated and catalogued.
Just how many undying are there?
Not nearly enough, milady. Yet we are glad to give our all in service to the Phoenix. Such is, and has ever been, our creed.
I see.
You have your associates, I have mine. But you may now think of them as ours. That won't be a problem, will it?
The Phoenix is our sun, and we but the shadows that quicken in his radiance. It is from the darkness that we serve, both him and now you. Pray accept this token.
Phoenix down!
For as long as you bear it, members of our order will reveal themselves unto you, if there is nothing further.
No. You are dismissed.
Your Grace.
It's a canva, then.
We'll talk about this later. Cyril seemed very, you certainly keep strange bedfellows, Joshua.
The free cities under sea?
Run like the... Are you sure this is the right way, brother?
It isn't. Not for the main mission, but we're not doing the main mission. that 46 desert roses.
You deserve a rest.
Well, they certainly are a pack. Really rank C, you guys.
You're a bicep total.
Unleash the beast! Took care of the pack. You're no longer the leaders of the pack. Easily amused.
Shouldn't have messed with the leader of the pack, eh, boy?
I just like that you can just watch the light outside the window get dark. Wasn't enough.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon.
Oh, I am 10 off. Are you fucking kidding me?
Come again. I may have more for you.
I need a side mission real quick. Gave me another 10 points. That's all I need is 10 more points. Oh, I can get it in before I start, hopefully.
Will we ever see the sun again?
There is no sun, only Zoom.
Is a storm coming, Sid? Will there be...
Sid, perhaps you can help me solve a mystery.
I can certainly try. Who's gone missing this time?
It's not who, but what. Mid-scales. The ones she made for her workshop. I borrowed them to teach the little ones about weight, and shortly after the lesson, they vanished. My first thought was that they'd taken them off somewhere to play, but when I asked, they swore they had nothing to do with their having disappeared, which almost certainly means they had everything to do with it.
They broke them.
Perhaps a visit from Sid will jog their memories.
I think it just might. Thank you. I don't like to imagine that my pupils would lie to me. But if they have, I'll have no choice but to discipline them accordingly. They were in the atrium when I last saw them. As always.
Be able to finish this before the storm hits. Run.
It seems the hideaway is lost. I heard the Emperor was impaled. What do you reckon we should do?
I just reckon you should be beaten.
Sid! Hard at your studies, I see. I What is that? It's not a set of scales, is it?
No. Of course it isn't.
Well, not anymore, it's not. Oh!
And just how long hasn't it been one?
We're sorry.
But we didn't break them. We dismembered them.
Just like Miss Middadol showed us.
Miss Middadol? Why would she have you dismembering her creations?
Because that's the only way to become a ninjaneer.
Miss Middadol said, the best way to see how something works is to take it apart and put it back together again.
Well, then your work is already half done. Carry on.
About that.
The taking apart was easy enough, but it's the putting back we can't work out.
Speak for yourself. The heavy thing goes at the bottom, so then...
You three need to learn to take responsibility for your actions. So let's have a look at these parts with fresh eyes, shall we? All right. Everything here was once part of Miss Middadol's scales. Every piece has its own role to play, and each is just as important as the others. If even one of them is missing, the scales won't work. So let's think about what those roles might be. You already know one of the pieces. The body. Its role is to support everything else. But what of the others? This is called the arm. Why do you suppose that is? It doesn't look much like an arm.
Because it holds things
right.
Up.
It looks more like a wing. Like a chocobo wing!
You've ridden a chocobo before, haven't you, Sid? Will you teach me to ride one day?
I'll probably think not. About it. Now, what do arms do?
Hold things. So wait, maybe this arm holds things too?
Good thinking. You're on the right track. These round parts are called the pans. You all know what a pan is, don't you?
I do. Molly uses them in the kitchens to fry bangers. But these aren't for frying bangers, you idiot. They're for weighing stuff. But what if I wanted to weigh goots? I don't think you'd fit on that little thing.
Probably not.
What are the chains for? Holding the pans up?
Well spotted. Which means something must hold the chains up in turn. This tiny piece is what's called a cogwheel, or gear. Have you ever seen one before?
I have. Miss Minidale's dungeon is full of them. Most are on the floor.
She puts them in all her inventions. They spin round and round and round.
That's right. They're very useful when you want to make things move. Do you remember if there was anything on the scales that moved?
I remember the arm moved when I tried weighing an apple. And then somebody ate it.
Well,
my fault? You shouldn't have tried weighing it before lunch.
You know what part's supposed to move and how it's supposed to move. So, let's put the pieces together first, see what doesn't move, and then stick the cogwheel to that.
Not a bad idea. You see? It's not so difficult.
And then once they repair it, so, you execute them.
Now that we've taken stock of the parts and learned what they do, what do you think?
I think we've got it.
Then here's what we'll do. You tell me what goes where, and I'll put the scales together.
Well, obviously you need to start with the body. All the other pieces fit onto it, don't they?
And the arms go on the body, just like real arms. Or wings, if you're a chocobo. And then the arms hold the pans by the chains.
Very good. Let's see if that works. There. All finished.
Yes! We did it!
Well, with Sid's help.
Oh, I just put the pieces together. It was you three engineers who showed me how.
That's right. We're Miss Middadol's hairs.
Her hairs?
Hairs, but
yeah.
Ultimate.
Hairs for the future. She's showing us her secrets now, so we can help out the hideaway when we're older.
What do you think, Sid? Are we almost ready?
With a little more help from Miss Middadol and Miss Shirley, I'd say it won't be long at all.
You hear that? It won't
be
long.
So you're all gonna lose your left hand. Until then, though,
do try to be honest with Miss Shirley.
Hey, Look, we never used the cogwheel.
You don't think Sid forgot about it, do you?
Ooh, darkness outside. I could have gone the other way, shouldn't I?
It was as you thought. The children had the scales, or the parts of them at least. They dismantled them to see how they worked.
Oh, no, Mid will have my head.
Thankfully she won't. This might even have been her idea, although I was the one who ended up teaching the lesson.
I'm so sorry, Sid. I know how busy you are. I shall see that the children are properly punished.
Please, there's no need. Mid seems to have taken the three of them under her wing. She's even calling them her heirs. She'd have them follow in her footsteps. And her father's.
I see.
Ooh, low blow there, Sid.
Sid, do you know why Mid has been spending so much time at the hideaway of late?
She told me it was because her studies have been interrupted by events in Canva. Is that not true?
No, it isn't. The university offered her a commission. In exchange for full tuition, room, and board, they asked her to oversee the design of several new war engines. To anyone else, it would be an opportunity. But to Mid, who lost both her parents to war, it was a bitter pill. One she was none too keen to swallow. But that should come as no surprise. She's only ever cared about bringing people hope. The very last thing war can be said to do.
Which explains her heirs. She's working to give them a better life. And so should I. What's the odd engineering lesson?
Oh, you've given them far more than that. And I'm sure they're very grateful.
Even though that side mission, we wouldn't have known that. I saw some people on Twitter bitching about the side missions, like, oh, there's no point in the side missions. But clearly there is. Could be enough. Thunder. Yep, we'll get this done real quick and I'll turn everything off. Womp womp.
Welcome to the Patron's Whisper. Your benefactors are a generous lot. All yours. All done?
Well, it says there's currently three people watching, so hi, three people. But, yeah, there's a storm coming in, so I'm turning everything off. Thank you guys for watching. As always, like, subscribe, comment down below, and have one hell of a day. I was really hoping to play more, but yeah, there's a storm coming. Can't do that. I could have easily played for another 2 hours. Especially since I'm off tomorrow. Maybe I'll try to play more tomorrow to make up for not being able to play as long as I wanted to today. See you guys.